Update. Am I the a-hole for kicking my boyfriend out over my cat? Original story. For context, my 24 female boyfriend 30 male and I recently moved in together. It's something we've been talking about, and when his lease ended, he moved into my apartment. I have a cat, Millie, who is my baby girl that I've had since she was a kitten. Back when my boyfriend and I first started dating, he made a joke that if we were ever going to live together, he'd have to get rid of that cat, which I dismissed at the time. When he would come over, he would ignore Millie, making jokes about how cats are stuck up, how much she's a dog person. Again, I dismissed this, because he never acted hostile towards her, and I figured it was just a preference. When we started to get serious about moving in, he asked if I would consider giving her away, because he didn't like the idea of living with a cat. He almost laughed before realizing he was serious. I told him that under no circumstances would I get rid of my cat. I felt guilty about being unwilling to compromise, but he actually took it well, and reassured me that if she was this important to me, he'd get over it. Fast forward to last night. I don't think he realized I was in the kitchen when he came home. Millie was on a couch, and I heard him go into the room and give the sigh. But before I could call out, I heard him say, "You're so freaking worthless." It terrified me because I've never heard him speak with such malice. He sounded like a different person. It was just so cold and hostile that I panicked and rushed out there to see him looking at Millie. Here's where I might be the a-hole. I completely freaked out. I was yelling, asking what he thought was doing talking to her like that. He jumped, and I scooped Millie up and told him to leave my apartment right now. He looked so stunned and started to argue, asking where was he supposed to go. I told him that I don't care. He just needs to leave. He was pissed and said he was going for a drive and slammed the door behind him. I immediately started sobbing and holding Millie. I was shaking, and she could tell I was upset and kept cuddling me. She calmed me down, and later when he texted asking if he could come back, I said yes. I put Millie in the bedroom so we could talk. We were both a lot calmer, and I felt awful after we explained aside. I'll often call Millie little names, and he said he was just trying to be playfully mean too and misjudged his tone. But he said it felt awful that I chose a cat over him, and that he called it my apartment when it's supposed to be our place. He told me he was constantly feeling second best to Millie, who I wouldn't even consider rehoming, and I had thrown him out over an animal when he's a person. I explained to him how much he means to me, and apologized for ever making him feel like this wasn't his home. I think he might have overreacted, but I just don't know. He's my boyfriend, and she's something I kept refusing to compromise on. But I also don't believe that he just misjudged his tone. Am I the a-hole? Top comments before reading the update. Not an a-hole, and he's lying now. Don't let him gaslight you. Your cat is going to go missing someday. This. If for some reason you do continue this, make sure you have plenty of photographs of her and you as proof that she's yours, and that she's microchipped because she will end up on the streets or dropped off at a shelter. Not an a-hole. Rehome your a-hole boyfriend. You shouldn't have dismissed those earlier jokes. On a first date, you should have said something like, "All jokes aside, I would never get rid of my cat." I can't be as unworthless comment being his attempt at being playful. He is just making up excuses because he caught him. Agreed. He got caught and came up with a BS excuse. Ditch him before the cat goes missing or worse. Not an a-hole. The way a person talks about an animal or treats an animal is a good indication of the type of person they are. After all the talk about wanting to get rid of her, I could never trust him alone with her. How do I know he won't poison her, physically hurt her, or dump on the side of the road? If it was my boyfriend, he would be gone. Flat out gone. If you don't like cats slash dogs, that's fine. But when you are just nasty about it, then you cross a line. Yep, if this is how he is when he thinks Opie isn't there and is his regular mood, I dread to think how he is in a bad mood. And now for the update. First of all, wow. I did not expect a flood of supportive comments, messages, and awards. I tried to respond to as many messages as I could, at least the ones that weren't wildly hateful, but I genuinely appreciated all of the kind words and concern for me and Millie. Everybody's comments were extremely eye-opening. I felt sick to my stomach reading about people afraid for Millie, and it had already crossed my mind honestly. Making that post validated all the fears that I had kept dismissing as dramatic, and it was almost a relief to be encouraged by strangers to do something I had previously been too afraid to do. so we broke up. It's my apartment. He wasn't on the lease yet and he's going to go stay with his brother. Had to read around about gaslighting, and my sisters would agree with all of you about that one. It was hard to lose somebody I trusted and thought I knew well, but based on his reaction, I knew I made a right call. He essentially told me that if I couldn't learn to put other humans before my cat, I'd be alone for a very long time, and that he'd be waiting for me to reach out. Millie doesn't deserve to just be tolerated. She deserves to be safe and treated like the little princess she is by anybody I live with. She's seen me through so much, and I'd rather be alone than her wandering around the side of the road somewhere. And I am absolutely terrified of her ever being hurt. It isn't worth the risk. I'm okay with it being just her and I for now. Thanks everybody for the advice. When my boyfriend moved in, he babied my cats so much, I'm pretty sure he was their favorite human. Dad was relegated to the position of backup slave. We since got another cat together. I could never date someone who didn't love animals. Good for you and Millie. There are better guys out there. Oh, my two cats are super babied by my boyfriend. He's their favorite person. Me, I'm just convenient when he's not around. Lol. My boyfriend kisses the top of his cat's heads. Now when they get pets from me, they present their heads for kisses sometimes. I do not deserve any one of them. I'm a dog person 100%, but I live with my significant other and his cat, and our dogs. The cat drives me crazy. He's up at 5 a.m, and for some reason he loves me more than my significant other, so he has to sit on my face in the morning. And he drools. What kind of cat drools? He also claws the furniture and screams like a tiny demon when you ignore him. Even with all that, I still love that little bastard, and I would never ask my significant other to get rid of him. He is family. He may be annoying as hell and I'm not a cat person at all, but he's still my little floofy baby. So what I'm saying is, good for you, Opie. You'll definitely find someone who will love you and your adorable cat. Cats drool just like dogs do, sometimes when they're hot, but mostly when they're happy and excited. We've got a senior cat outside named Jack. All you have to do is talk to him a bit, and he goes gaga for potential pets and will start drooling everywhere. Yes, girl. I'm sitting here with my old man cat. I've had him for 15 years, longer than I've had my husband. If I'd had to have gotten rid of this cat for a man, I would not get to see him spend his senior years cuddled up with my daughter who adores him. I wouldn't trade that for anything. You'll find someone that respects Miss Millie and loves her as much as you do. He essentially told me that if I couldn't learn to put other humans before my cat, I'd be alone for a very long time, and that he'd be waiting for me to reach out. Holy cow, you made a right call. I love my fiancé, but if he told me I had to choose between him or my two fur babies, he'd be out so freaking fast his head would spin. Next story is titled, Am I the A-hole for greatly increasing my husband's chores and dismissing his complaints after he called me a homemaker? Context. I work in my own startup. Husband John works in a movie theater. Before I started my company, we both had similar income, but now I earn 5 times as much as him. The chore dynamic at home was always heavily skewed. I'm very neat and like cooking, so I handled the lion's share of chores on top of my job. After the company started growing, John invested himself more in chores because he was staying at home due to movie theaters being closed. His workplace reopened a few months ago and he immediately stopped doing most chores. I have been lenient and doing more than my share since he comes home every day exhausted and complaining. After work, he does nothing but leisure, totally overlooking the fact I manage our household on top of running my company. I'm kind of a doormat sometimes, so I let it go because I want to be kind to John. But last weekend, he crossed a line. I work 7 days a week, John has weekends off, and he was playing video games all day while I was working, and he came to ask me when lunch would be ready. I told him that I am very busy with work, and can he cook for once? He declined, then complained that it was so much easier in his grandfather's time, when the homemaker didn't do anything other than her duties. I exploded. We had the biggest screaming match in our lives, with him calling himself the breadwinner of the household, repeatedly hiding behind the claim that he goes out to work, as opposed to me working from home, which means I'm a housewife, huh? I steamrolled his claims by pointing out that I earn much more money than him. I work longer hours and still do all the chores. I told him to quit his job and dedicate all of his time to chores. Since he is so enamored with the simpler times of homemakers and breadwinners, even if he became unemployed, our financial situation wouldn't change. He acted appalled. Monday, I gave him a list of chores to do, about 2 to 3 hours of chores daily. He constantly complains, and I just reply with, quit your job. I spent years doing all the chores on top of my job, but he whines at the prospect of doing just half. Tuesday night, he told me he refused to do the chores, and I couldn't force him. I shouted him down into submission, telling him that I spent our entire common life picking up the ball that keeps dropping, and that his choice to work an unskilled job for pocket change does not preclude him from helping me, the breadwinner, keep this household in shape. Yesterday, I locked up his PS5 in our safe and changed the combination. This is not in my nature. I'm usually polite and soft-spoken, and I feel like an a-hole when I see him looking like a sad puppy and whining that he is tired. But I just snapped. I feel like I don't have a choice. If I let John do nothing and consider himself the breadwinner who deserves to come home to a clean house and warm meal through no effort of his own, I would lock myself into a life of servitude. Am I an a-hole? Now for the comments. Oh my girl, you're most definitely not an a-hole. In fact, don't you dare take even the tiniest step back. Hold your ground as if your life depended on it. Edit. I would very much like to know the gender of the people who will vote either you're the a-hole or everyone sucks here. You and I both. For people saying, oh, but the way she spoke to him isn't right. Her husband is being a sexist, lazy, disrespectful pig, and quite literally trying to invalidate her success and value in the marriage. I challenge anyone who thinks she is also an a-hole to try living with a significant other like that and not changing their tune. Not an a-hole. Sounds like you've been picking up his slack for a while. How dare he make claims about you being a homemaker when you're apparently bringing in the majority of the money? Working from home is work. I doubt working at the movie theater is very lucrative. Stop picking up his slack. He is being disrespectful of you, your job, and everything you do for your home. How dare he make claims about you being a homemaker when you're apparently bringing in the majority of the money? I know, right? This is exactly the thought that sent me over the metaphorical line. The answer is that, since I'm at home all day, and I get to choose my hours since I'm the boss, while he is at his workplace all day, that's all he considered. The fact I work more hours and earn a lot more money never crossed his mind, I guess. That's also how he'd justify not doing chores to himself, I concluded after thinking on it a while. He did his part by doing his job, so he expects to come home and do nothing more, since he put in his hours. The fact that he had this unspoken belief that I'm his housewife, that really grated my nerves like nothing else ever did. I hope the intimacy is amazing, because you're getting screwed. Not stay home. To be honest, it is. Not stay home. But why? Why are you with someone who treats you like this? This is the third post today I've seen with a similar theme. The real deep reasons would require hours with a therapist to untangle, as is often the case with human relationships. Probably a mix of childhood trauma, me being very socially awkward, sunk cost fallacy, etc., etc., etc. The concrete day-to-day reasons that were observable to me? I answered it this way in another comment. We were college sweethearts, when it doesn't matter if the other is a bit lazy or kind of a slob. He stopped at his bachelor's, while I continued all the way up to my PhD, and he supported me financially through it all. I supported him in turn for years after I graduated. We are now in the stage of adulthood where it's very hard to start dating again, and I genuinely love John. If he could step up his act, I think we could find again this stability and great synchronicity between us. Now for the last story. Am I the a-hole for telling my boyfriend that his daughter can't have her own room in our house? So, my boyfriend 30 male and I 24 female have been together for 2 years, and we just bought our first house together, and we moved in at the end of the month. My boyfriend has a 4-year-old daughter, Kate, from a previous relationship. I love Kate with all of my heart. She lives with my boyfriend's ex, and comes to visit us for short stays and sleepovers, more often in the summertime. Our new house is about a 30-minute drive from Kate's mom's house. It has 3 bedrooms, a master bedroom and 2 smaller bedrooms. We are converting one of the rooms to be an office for my boyfriend and me to work from. That leaves just 1 spare bedroom. Kate was really nervous about us moving so far away, and my boyfriend has reassured her that she will still get to visit all the time, and she will have her own bedroom waiting for her whenever she wants. My issue with this is that I don't want Kate to treat the only spare bedroom as her personal bedroom. Rather, I want it to be thought of as a guest bedroom. Of course, Kate can stay there whenever she wants to. This isn't part of the debate, as I want her to feel welcome all the time. But I don't want it to be only her room. I don't want it to be filled with her toys and clothes, so nobody else feels comfortable to sleep in there. I don't think it's fair that a room is reserved for someone who is not there 90% of the time. In addition, my boyfriend and I are planning to have a child of our own, and I want to make sure that when that happens, we will have a space for them to live. I can only imagine the circus in a few years if we have to tell Kate we are taking away her room to give to her new sibling. That's why I want to set expectations now, that Kate is always welcome, but she will be welcome as a guest. My boyfriend thinks I'm being unreasonable, that Kate needs her own room for stability, especially as she feels we are moving away from her. He says we can keep a pull-out sofa in our office for guests to stay on, and call the spare room Kate's room. I still don't think it's fair to have a room just for Kate when she won't use it very often. And I think it's reasonable to be worried at the prospect of eventually giving Kate's room away to a future child. You're the a-hole. I am not surprised that you didn't discuss this beforehand, because it would be obvious to anyone with a heart that a 4-year-old is not a guest in her father's house. It is her other home. Of course she gets a room there. Seriously, you should go apologize profusely to your boyfriend and his daughter, if you have already spoken to her about this. Apparently, they did, and her boyfriend made it clear he intended one of the rooms to be for Kate, but she somehow misunderstood and thought that just meant a room with a bed, minus all of her belongings, and that it would be temporary. I can't imagine how dense or heartless this woman could possibly be to think that the father of this little girl just meant, I'll give Kate a room to sleep until someone else more important comes along to fill that room, which is what Opie here was thinking. You're the a-hole. She's a child. A 4-year-old. And you want to make sure she knows that isn't her room? Marinate on that. You want to make sure a 4-year-old isn't too comfortable or at home in her dad's home. If I were him, I'd leave you. Oh my god, I didn't even think this deep. But that is exactly what's happening. I am in awe of Opie's post. It is unbelievable. You're the a-hole. She's not a guest. She's his daughter. My stepson lives 4 hours away and we get him on school breaks and during the summer. The rest of the time his room is closed off, so the cats can't wreak havoc. It's not wasted space. It's his room. And when he comes back, he knows his Nerf guns and video games and other toys are safely awaiting him in his room. You say you want her to feel welcome, but how is she supposed to feel that when she's not even worthy of having her own space? Crap like this is why step-parents get such a bad rep.